G'day guys, I thought I'd just show you a couple of busts today. I'm sure some of you guys will get pretty excited about that, especially the teenage boys. This is some of the 1/9 scale busts I've picked up over my time, and I just thought I'd show you this one to start off with. This is your life miniatures bust, but I just wanted to give you an example of this is what you can buy now, and it's a very nice bust, great paint job. And the sculptor's amazing. He's done a lot in this range. But before, you sort of had these guys and Alpine Miniatures and Evolution Miniatures, which are all great companies, and I love their figures and their busts. I just thought I'd show you some of the old ones. Now, this is one of those magazines, a bit like the old Tamir magazines that I used to, and Verlinden books that I used to pore over when I was a bit younger. As you can see, this is from 1997. It's a calendar of Warriors, which was a fantastic company that did a lot of 135 scale figures and busts in 1/9 scale and lots of different things. And this was a company that was huge for me when I was sort of growing up, and really loved all the figures. Prior to that, I used to do a lot of Verlinden stuff, but I found that these figures were probably, well, some of them anyway, were really nice. But this sort of what got me into the large scale figures, the 1/9 scale, and I'll just show you a quick flick through to a section that I quite liked, and that was getting into the sort of 120mm section. These are some of the 120mm figures that they used to do, and I really liked some of these figures as well. That one there, I think, was a John Rosengrant figure. This one up here, I think, was a John Rosengrant figure, who's one of my favourite sculptors. And just really, really nice figures. Come over here. Some nice 200mm, 1/9, or 1/9 scale, which one you want to call it. Figures, I think this might be another John Rosengrant figure. And one of my favourites was this one here. They're pretty hard to get now, these figures. Sometimes you can get some really bad recasts of these figures. So if you can find an original, that's your first bet. That's a really nice figure that I liked quite a lot. That's another John Rosengrant figure. And did a lot of busts. This bust here is a nice bust as well. That's a John Rosengrant figure, I believe, or bust, I should say. And, here's another one. That's a really nice figure I had. Oh, light from John Rosengrant. Even just the little background and the groundwork. Even today, if you put that into a model show, you'd come off with a medal. It's just unbelievable. And this is back in 1997 or even earlier. And just amazing. Just amazing type of work. I'll just quickly, this company's out of out of production now, or it's not a viable business anymore, and they closed down. But it's a real shame. Some of their figures, you're lucky enough to probably find on eBay, because you have a lot of collectors that maybe are getting a little bit older now. They're selling some of their collections off, and you can pick up some of this stuff around on eBay if you're looking. But some of the Warriors stuff, the 135 scale stuff, you can still pick up on eBay reasonably easily. Some figures are very hard to find. These two guys here are quite hard to find. They're a nice German set. I've seen a couple of dioramas done with these guys lately. But yeah, that's a really nice set, and I also believe that might have been sculpted by John Rosengrant as well. And he used to go along with kind of this little fella here, who's again sculpted by John, I think. But yeah, really nice figures. And I'll just show you the book again. Really nice catalogue. Some of these old catalogues are great if you can just pick them up. And sometimes you can get it really cheap, and you can flick through and you go, oh geez, that's a nice figure. And then you can sort of try and track it down for straight away, or 2 or 3 years it might take you to find one. But yeah, really nice figure. And sometimes if you get on planetfigure.com, you can get into their sales section, and you might be lucky enough, and some people will be selling some stuff in there from time to time. But yeah, really, really nice little catalogue of Warriors. So, the reason why I kind of showed you that catalogue was because I thought I would also show you a couple of these that are quite rare these days. As I was saying, they're hard to get. And these are some of the busts that you can find, if you're very lucky, from time to time. Now, as I said before, my favourite sculptor at the moment, Alpine's pretty much up there as well. But John Rosengrant, that's one of his there, as you can see. Put up his name. If you can't understand what I'm saying, from a different country and all that sort of stuff, you know what I'm talking about, mate. So that's one of John's, and this is another one of John's, which I really like as well. But as you can see, just for the time ago this was done, he was just so talented then, but even now he's still sculpting figures. He just did the two German figures in 1/16 scale for Alpine, the MG42 guy and the MO carrying guy, and they're just beautiful figures as well. But enough about Alpine, this is about Warriors today, and I'll go through Alpine on another day. But I'll just show you some of what these are like. So, oh, also another name that I'm not too sure about, Tony Williams. I'm sure he's a very well-known sculptor and everything like that. I haven't got too many of his figures, so that's why I'm not too sure about him. But I'm sure in the model community, he's a very well-known person. But I do know Chris Crossgrove. I did buy his 1/9 scale John Rosengrant machine gunner that was just released probably a year or two ago now, 1/9, and that was a beautiful figure. So thank you very much for that, Chris. And I think I almost had, Chris's SAS 135 scale crew for the Jeep that Chris did as well, which I also liked, and I think John was part of that when he did his SAS little dio with his little Jeep, and I think a lot of people looked at that, and I think that might have sparked, John sculpted those figures, but he didn't produce them. And I think that might have sparked some of the other SAS figures that are 135 scale that are out today. But enough of me gas bagging. I thought what I would do is just show you a couple of these beautiful busts that are out there somewhere. And I thought I'd show you the quality of these, given that they were done such a long time ago, but still are up to, well and truly up to today's standard. I'll just show this little fella here, if I can. So this is the first one, and that's that box there. This one I find pretty hard to find these days on eBay. Sorry about that, I just wanted to bring this to your attention. I just looked at one of my other boxes, and this is a figure set I absolutely love, again from Warriors. This is a 135 scale, but I just checked the box, and it was Tony Williams again. So, and Trevor Hensley, I do know. I think he might have done something for SNT, possibly, Productions. But, yep, Tony, if you're out there, I love these figures. Beautiful figures, took me a while to get, but absolutely great poses. Very nice. All right, back to the Grenada SS Division by John Rosengrant. Now look at this, look at the sculpting on this. Probably one of the most annoying thing, apart from John being in the movie industry, John Rosengrant being in the movie industry, doing things like Terminator, Iron Man. Oh, he's done many, many movies. Real Steel, is it? One of the Toy Soldiers. Just so many movies. Every time I look up the internet, I realise he's done something else, old or new. But one of the things I was saying about John is that not only does he sculpt his own figures, but he also does the box art for his own figures, which is, if that was done early in the 1990s, his painting skills are just amazing then. So God knows what he's doing with them now, but that's just amazing. Obviously, he's in the movies, but yeah, that's probably some of these box arts are the things that actually got me to buy the figure in the first place. So, your figure companies out there, make sure you get a good painter to do your box art, because sometimes I've seen box arts that have turned me off a figure, and then I've actually gone to a model show and I've seen the figure done by a good painter, and then I've actually gone back later on and bought the figure again, just because the box art painting turned me off the first time. But look at that. Beautiful. Love your work, John. Keep up your work. Might make it a little bit easier just to get a glimpse of what they are. Alrighty. On to the next one. Alright. On to the next one. Another beautiful painted figure by, sculpted and painted by John Rosengrant. Gotta love the figure. I'll turn this box over just in case anyone's desperately looking for it. There's the code. And just beautiful. Made in the USA. That's nice to know, isn't it? It's pretty rare these days for some things, isn't it? There's just some of the extra pieces I'll just show you. I'll just sort of show you some of the hands that John sculpts. They're the things that I just think are amazing. Look at that, just the veins that he has going running through the hands at that scale, 1/9 scale. Just beautiful. But again, you cannot tell me that this, look at the folds in that uniform. The face. Must be a nicely sculpted face. My video camera here has kept on putting a little box around the face, identifying that it is an actual face and trying to focus on that. So good on you, Mr. Video Camera. Love your work. Beautiful. Beautiful. Now, as I said before, I really do like this figure as well. Great sculpting. Look at the box art on that. Again, the box art made me buy this figure. But I just thought I'd show you in comparison. Now, this head is a little bit bigger. But this is today's, what's this? Probably, I don't know when it was done, 2014, 2013. Face is just a little bit bigger, of course. But I'll try and put these two little fellas together. ...1997 or earlier, and probably around, I don't know, 2013, somewhere around there, maybe later. Still, really both beautiful casts. And on to the last one, sculpted by Tony Williams and painted by Chris Crosco. Sorry, Chris, I've got to pronounce your name wrong. There it is. And I'm actually, apologise about this, but this one hasn't even been taken out of the bag yet. It's still sealed in the bag, so I'm going to keep it in the bag. But I'll just sort of show you his face. There you go. I love this little backpack that he's got on, or whatever he's got around the back there. Sorry for the name, the canteen obviously, and some sort of blanket, Zeta Barn, maybe not a Zeta Barn, something looks like some sort of blanket coat. Apologies for not knowing the name of that. But again, another beautiful sculpted bust by Warriors. Alright guys, hope you didn't mind that. Hope I did. We'll catch you later.